Arkadaşlar merhaba, Kripto Emre'ye hepiniz hoş geldiniz. Bugün sizler için kanalımda yine çok çok özel bir misafirim var. Algorand ekibinden Jason benimle. Jason Weathersby burada. Kendisiyle Algorand'daki son gelişmeleri konuşacağız. Bir de Algorand'ın platform üstü geliştirmelerle ilgili bir projesi var. Bunu detaylarıyla bizimle paylaşıyor olacak. Hey Jason, welcome to the channel.
Thank you for having me.
How are you?
I'm doing well. How about yourself?
I'm also doing fine. I mean, I can't complain when the markets are picking up. So, let's get started. Like, tell us a bit about yourself. I mean, when and how did you get into crypto?
Yeah, I don't know if it's an interesting story, but it's a story. I graduated university with an electrical engineer's degree. So, and my first job was in doing plant automation. So I wrote control software for, pharmaceuticals like Tylenol, that type of thing. And I did that work for about 10 years, and that led into doing a lot of data analysis. So at that time, I talked with some companies out of San Francisco, and one of them was interested in doing an open source project on in data analytics. So I joined that project, helped grow that project, and did things like, I was the main evangelist for the product, wrote a couple books on the subject, and then. As I was doing that, everything was web-based at the time, and at the time Mozilla was growing, growing well, and I got recruited over to go to Mozilla to run their developer relations group. So I did that for several years, and then as part of being at Mozilla, we were in this emerging technologies group, which really focused on things like VR, WebAssembly, Rust, AI, machine learning, and blockchain. And that's when I became exposed to blockchain. And I didn't look at blockchain like the way a lot of people do is from a cryptocurrency standpoint. While the cryptocurrency stuff is fun and it's in my opinion, good investments. But from a standpoint of transformative technology, I always thought blockchain had so many more use cases. And from that perspective alone, that led me to think this could be a industry changing type technology, and I wanted to be involved in it. Well, that got me involved with the Algorand project, and they asked me to run their developer relations group there. So I moved over to Algorand. So that's kind of how I got this long route to Algorand.
That's actually pretty cool. I mean, I also did an interview last year with John McAfee, the infamous John.
Yeah.
And he said that like blockchain was the biggest invention after, what was agriculture. I mean, like he was that bold. So I feel like you also share the same, point of view, because it's really transformative technology. So speaking of transformations, I mean, Algorand has been doing great. So what are you guys are up to lately?
Yeah. So, well, obviously I'm telling you, I don't think I've ever been this busy in my life. As part of developer relations, some of the things that we do is obviously we maintain our developer portal, we give talks, and most of them, fortunately for us today, are online. That way we can do other things and get more tasks done as opposed to traveling places. That said, that's the only good thing about Corona, right? So, one of the other things we do is I like to refer to developer evangelists as developer advocates, because part of their job is to go back to engineering and make sure you make the product better. You want to build what the engineers and developers that are using your product want, right? So a lot of time we spend a great deal of time doing that, working with the engineering team. We're very tight with the engineering team, and then in addition to that, we have a lot of partners. And as these partners, I think you talked to Kelly earlier, we announce something routinely, a new partner, a new partner, a new partner. Well, my team spends a great deal of time working with those partners, helping them get up to speed, understand the technology, and get them going on building product, right? So so from that standpoint, we stay completely busy. But from an Algorand perspective, you look at things like, we got all these stable coin projects like USDC, Tether, Meld for doing gold. Got QCAD bringing the Canadian dollar to Algorand, Monerium bringing the krona and the euro and soon the British pound to the blockchain. Those are cool projects. But then we got, I don't know how familiar you are with Algorand assets, but these are single click creation capability tokens that you can create, right? It's not, you don't have to do an ERC-20 contract, no contract codes required. It's one simple command to create a token on Algorand. Well, so we have a lot of asset tokenization projects like Relio that's tokenizing real estate investments. And significant transactions that we're getting today are things like Props, which is a loyalty-based program built on Algorand, and then Planet Watch, which is, you know, doing air quality sensors and writing that data to the blockchain. So those are some of the cool projects. I mean, you know, projects are ongoing right now, and we get literally there's so many of them. I lose track of how many we got going on at the moment. But in addition, from my standpoint, from the developer relations team, we spend a great deal of time working with accelerators, pre-accelerators, hackathons, things like that, right? And we just finished up the ENCODE pre-accelerator, which is a really was a bunch of great teams building cool things out of Algorand. And I'll give you a couple instances of the projects that were created on that. We got things like AlgoDuino, which is a IoT based applications for Algorand, so you could hook up your IoT apps directly to the chain. And we don't have a whole lot of games on Algorand yet, so it was nice to see we got a game called Footium coming to Algorand, which is, think of it as like a football management or soccer management game that you can play on Algorand. And then we got Isomorph for doing asset trading between Algorand and Ethereum. QVote was another interesting project. They actually did a mock election during the election time for the president of the United States. It's a quadratic voting application that runs on it. But one of the most interesting to me personally, and I'll tell you why, because this is one of these projects that I think sees the future, is a project called Authenium, and they're out of Australia, and their whole project was to match buyers and sellers without a centralized party in the food space. So what they had is farmers growing stuff, and they wanted to match them up with buyers for their crops without having to pay such an exorbitant fee to facilitate that matching. And so and to me, that's the transformative nature right there of blockchain. It had very little to do with cryptocurrency, had everything to do with what the power of blockchain is, matching buyers and sellers without a central authority. And to me, that is so much more powerful than just finance. Even though finance is transformative in itself, there's so many other use cases, which makes the space interesting.
Mm-hmm. I totally agree. And I actually really admire you guys as a team, because you're actually spending a lot of resources and time on building this developer community. I mean, I remember you guys refreshing the developer portal, but then you guys also started with the dev office hours, which was kind of like a first time thing in the industry. So could you also tell us a bit about that program and how it's going?
Yeah. So to me, though, we love our developer office hours because it gives us an opportunity to actually meet with the developers. We get as much out of it as we give, right? And part of our job is to tell the product teams what we need built, right? And it's a great opportunity to interact with developers. It also gives us a great place to showcase new developer tool projects that are coming out of the grants programs, things like that, right? And so we've done a lot of work on making sure that we're getting content, really good content for the developer office hours. But that's just a continuation of the portal stuff. We made all these changes to the portal that make it much more refined. As you can, if you've been on it, you know that the documentation is robust, and to the point where it's can be complex for certain people. So we're actually investing in some new technology on top of that to do discrete learning modules that can be incentivize developers to learn in small consumable chunks. And so think of it like a learning path where you learn Algorand, right? And so we're doing things like that. We're also going to do it in a very interactive way. I can't wait to show this off once we get going on it, but it's going to be some really interactive things that I think developers will like, and hopefully it'll grow more adoption. In addition to that, you know, we spend a lot of time on Discord. We're trying to grow Discord channel. That's doing well. But we also do partner series trainings for all our partners. So I think this is what I was talking about, the team being so busy, right? As we have our hands in so many things that we get very little time during the day now.
Cool. So the program is in English only, right? Like
yeah. Currently, right now, we are looking at internationalization of a lot of the content. Like I said, we just launched a portal in Chinese, for example. So hopefully, we'll have a lot more things that come out to make it more much more international.
I think what you guys started will eventually evolve into something much more bigger, and like it will automatically create localized communities. Because as far as I know, I also advised the government about blockchain tech here in Turkey, and then there was this engineer at the presidency of Turkey who was actually going to do his thesis on the Solidity language for Ethereum. And then I introduced him to Algorand, and now he actually decided to write the entire book in Turkish about how to develop, you know, on the Algorand platform with Teal. So, I mean, the technology is cool for people who understand good technology. Yep. So, yeah.
I'm so glad to hear that.
Yeah, I mean, it was really interesting to have him switch from, you know, Ethereum to Algorand. So that's always a cool story. I also had an interview like last year with Navid about the Algorand grant program. Is that still on? Is it possible for people to, you know, use your office hours and then create a cool project and ask for a grant?
Certainly. From the foundation standpoint, we have several ways developers can earn algos. And one of those is a grant. One's also called a developer rewards program. A grant, think of it as I'm applying before I do the work. Rewards are I built this project. I want to bring it to you. Can I get a reward for that? And then we have things called bounties, which are if we need a particular feature, we'll put a bounty on it and get developers to build it, right? And then we also have, if you're a giver, we have a program associated with, if you develop content for the developer portal to help others learn, you can earn algos doing that as well. So we're providing a lot of different ways developers can earn algos and participate in the economy on Algorand and help others as well. So, but I will tell you that we got a lot of our projects have come out of the grant program, but some of the cool ones from a developer perspective are some of the tooling that's come out. For example, we have the Algo Signer project. It is think of it as kind of the MetaMask equivalent for Algorand. So you could, if you've got it's a Chrome plugin that you can plug in and make API calls to get the sign transactions, things like that within your application without doing any key management yourself, which is, it's a must have and if you're going to be building web apps. And then another big project is called Reach. And what Reach does, if you're familiar with Teal, Teal is our low-level smart contract language, and to me, it's not all that difficult. But for some people, they might find it hard or might not like the syntax of it. But Reach is a tool that basically is a framework that allows that it builds all the smart contracts for you. All you have to do is implement the project's business logic. So you put a set of business logic in there. And it ripples through, creates all the smart contracts for you, and even has a deployment mechanism. So, from a standpoint, and it's written in a JavaScript-like language, so it'll be very familiar to folks coming from Solidity and other parts of the web. So that's a really cool project. We got another one called AlgoDesk.io, which is point and click, deploy an asset right away, deploy a smart contract, write some smart contract code, all within the web. Mm. Then we got another project called Algo Builder. You're familiar with Truffle. It's similar to Truffle. It's an entire framework suite that we got a team building. And then another one, which I think is if you're an IntelliJ user, we got a plugin for IntelliJ that allows you. It's called Algo Dia, and it does virtually everything you can do on Algorand, including create multi-sig accounts, sign multi-sig transactions, atomic groups, all that with just single clicks, and just enter a little bit of data and do it, and it does it for you. And then we got other tools like Algorand Playground, which is a web-based playground to let you run our JavaScript SDK. If you're familiar, we have four SDKs: Java, JavaScript, Go, and Python. Well, this one does the JavaScript, some of the JavaScript SDKs you can run and manipulate, play with. You can also do some stuff around smart contracts. And then we got Algorand Studio, which is a full IDE, or it can also, alternatively, it can come as a plugin for VS Code if you're used to using VS Code, which is what I use. So, and it has many of the same types of feature, key management. It also has an integrated block explorer, things like that.
I see. I mean, It all sounds amazing. I mean, you guys are both supplying like really cool tech so people can easily build on the Algorand platform. And at the same time, you're also holding hands so people can actually utilize all this. I mean, I feel like once compatibility issues are solved, this is going to just fly off, because right now, like you just said, that it's possible to create ASAs similar to ERC-20s with just a click. I mean, I don't need to write a smart contract. But when I go to an exchange, ask for them to list that token, they need to have some compatibility. That's where the main players are actually having the advantage right now. But I think that's going to change really soon, because right now with the DeFi craze, I mean, the transaction fees on Ethereum is just like unacceptable. I mean, this cannot go on forever. So
and the transaction fees on Algorand are fractions of a cent.
Yeah, and the speed of the blockchain is also really, really, really insane. I mean, like I just did a transfer last month to a friend just to showcase how the wallet works, and it was just immediate. I mean, like you wouldn't believe it. That was blockchain if I didn't know how it worked. So yeah, speaking of cool tech, do you have any sneak peeks about like what the core teams building on Algorand?
Yeah, I gotta be very careful not to get in any trouble here. But you were speaking of performance there, right? Right now we do 1,000 transactions per second in less than 5 seconds. Yeah, and block times are less than 5 seconds. And what's interesting about our technology, and this is not picked up on a lot of the trading sites, is we have instant transaction finality. Once your transaction winds in a block, it can't be undone. It's there. And so you think about that. That's point of sale type speed. You really hope to see the attraction grow in a wider world in development to say, hey, we can instantly, this transaction is going to be, I mean, point of sale type speeds, right? This is buy something on Amazon type speed.
Yeah.
You want to know some of the things we're working on. One of the things, obviously, is we're working on performance improvements. We got visibility up to 46,000 transactions per second, and 2.5 second block times. That's a significant jump, right? And then currently you can put up to 5,000 transactions in a block. Well, we hope to grow that up to 25,000 transactions per block, and all while keeping that type of same speed. So that's not, you don't go from 1K to 46K in one release. That's just not what happens. But so our first goal we're working on now is to hit that 10K goal. And so that'll be our first one. That'll be our first step that we're trying to go. And that's, we're working on performance improvements. That's a key area. Another key area we're working on is, you talked about smart contracts. If you know Teal, Teal's a non-Turing complete language. You can't loop backwards. Well, some of the things we were looking at changing is adding looping. With some caveats. Here's the caveats: is currently we have a static execution cost calculation. So what it does is it goes through your entire Teal program and says, okay, this opcode costs this much. This opcode costs this much. All that's added up. If you got more opcode costs than you do have, than a certain number, then that smart contract can't run. Well, the way we're looking to change that mode to be dynamic execution cost. So if you do looping and you get it stuck in an infinite loop or something like that, you're going to run out of execution time and the transaction will be rejected. So we're going to have this dynamic execution cost field that allows things like looping. And then another key stickler point for people who are developing applications, we have stateful and stateless smart contracts on layer one. These layer one contracts, one of them, the stateless ones can approve transactions, spending transactions. Stateful cannot. Well, we're looking to change that and just go ahead and add approval of spending transactions from stateful smart contracts. That'll simplify the need to link smart stateful and stateless contracts together, which to me, I've done so many on almost every app I've built for Algorand. I've had to do that. So it's a convenience feature that should make things much, much nicer. And also, like if you have an escrow account, think of this. Anytime you submit a transaction from that escrow, you have to supply the logic with a stateless contract. In a stateful contract, you don't. The contract itself lives on the chain. So So the code's there, right? And then the one of the other things we're adding to it is we're looking to add function calls to layer one smart contracts, which all of those are, there's a lot of improvements for, and I don't know exactly when we'll get these, but these are the things that we're looking at for layer one smart contracts. We're also obviously still working on layer two contracts. I think that's a fairly well-known subject for Algorand, but it's you know, written in Clarity, larger programs, larger storage, more you get more computational power, you know, and should be much cheaper than running Ethereum smart contracts. In addition to that, we're working on code chains, and that's probably a fairly well-known subject as well, where we, you know, you can start your own private network and it's gatewayed to the main chain, and you can control consensus, staking, validators, all any the way you want to, and then the transactions conform to Algorand mainnet through the gateways. And so that so we're working on co-chains. That would be another one. And another one is we're working on trustless token bridge for, you know, passing tokens back and forth between chains and things like that. So yeah, so I don't know when any of that when the token bridge stuff will be. I can't put any dates on any of that. These are just some of the things I know we're working on in engineering at the time.
No, they all sound really interesting, and I can, you know, imagine the technical difficulties in, you know, building these, because you're actually working on a live system. So I mean, nothing can go wrong, because I mean the amount of transactions you guys are already handling is yep. like super high. So yeah, I mean, good luck with all these developments, but these are all promising and exciting news. So I mean, I think we established that you're a tech guy and not that interested in the, you know, speculation part, the finance part. But still, I'd really like to hear your opinion about like what has been happening in the markets lately. I mean, like for example, what do you think about this, you know, Wall Street Bets channel on Reddit? Like,
I'm gonna be very careful to say anything on that. You know, I gotta be honest with you. The crypto side of me goes, good for them, right? But part of the reason I like crypto is because the power, it's decentralization of power, not just money. And that is the biggest reason. I think I spent my entire career working in Silicon Valley, where you've got these big tech companies that have so much power. And if you're not one of them, then you don't get to participate. You don't get to play in the playground, right? And so to me, decentralizing not just money, but power is a good thing, not just for one technology space. It's a good thing for the world. And so I'm looking at it with too much pie in the sky type eyes, but that's what I see. That's what I see. And so if you go to the Wall Street Bet, I think some of it's silliness and all that. But in the same respect, I also think, you know what, it's definitely flipping things around a little bit. So, you know, whatever that may mean. All right.
Yeah, I mean, like it was an interesting, you know, movement, but yeah. I mean, they managed to, you know, seal that in, but still, I totally agree about your opinions on you know, decentralizing power, because like when someone grabs a lot of power, then it tends to, you know, corrupt that, you know, entity or
exactly.
person.
Yeah, exactly.
Kind of like physics. I mean, so yeah, I mean, I also do hope that blockchain tech, you know, changes things for the better in the world. So
yep, I certainly hope so. And I will say this, you know, if you look at where the market's going, there. It's cryptocurrency, so the only thing we can really say is tomorrow will not be like today. That's the only thing I think we know for certain in the crypto world. But you're seeing a lot more mainstream adoption, and people are starting to see these much more versatile use cases that that blockchains can be used for. And so I think you'll see a lot of growth, and there's so much potential for growth. I always tell everybody, can you imagine Amazon without Amazon Inc.? That's what the power of matching buyers and sellers can do, in my opinion. So when we start, and without totally enriching one segment of the population, and being a much more equitable approach to dealing with you know consumers. So from my standpoint, I see that there's the area there. There's the need there, so and the developers are coming there, so I think that it can't help but grow and adopt.
Yeah, I totally agree. And this has been really, you know, pleasing. So thanks for, you know, sparing the time to chat with me today. I hope everybody enjoyed this interview. So yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. And like, finally, where can we follow all these development news?
Yeah. Join our Discord channel. The link for that will be on the developer.algorand.org site. It's at the bottom. Just click our Discord channel. We also have forums. Make sure you join there. And obviously, join our. We have links on the developer site for joining our developer office hours. Please join them. We'd love to have as many people as we can there. Ask questions. Get involved. And if you're interested in working on any projects, DM me on Discord, and I'll connect you with the right folks.
Awesome. So I hope the Turkish developer community, you know, takes advantage of all these benefits. So yeah, I mean, thanks again for doing this, and yeah, looking forward to speaking with you soon.
Nice meeting you, and nice talking with you.
Yeah, same here. You have a great day.